So first, let us have the slide of the Anish. I'm waiting for this slide, or you can just tell me that the slide is on. Okay. So Sri Anish is like a Triveni Sangam, someone who excelled in HR, someone excelled an entrepreneur, and today he is excelled as a spiritual teacher. So you will see that journey. So his recent book, Let the Mud Settle, it's on Amazon, and it's received compliments and kudos from all, including people like Dr. Karan Singh. So welcome, Sri Anish. You have agreed to moderate the session once again. Thank you. So we will move on. We have four panelists. One is Dr. VP Singh. Like with love, I call him Rajarshi. So he was a successful Raja, he was a successful Rishi. He has excelled both in the corporate world and the academic world. In the corporate world, he has worked with large corporates, for the CHRO. He was with Patanjali. He's now leading a large coaches network. He guides a number of institutions, universities. So welcome, Dr. VP Singh. Welcome, Dr. I'm keeping the slide on so that you can go through. So next panelist is Dr. Tanuja Sharma from MDI. You just see a rich background. She's from University of Delhi. She's currently with MDI. Her doctoral work has received Mercer Award, and she has several research publications to her credit. And she works on contemporary topics like happiness, dignity work, gender across generation, and mindfulness. So welcome, Dr. Tanuja Sharma. So move on. Yeah, this can be the shortest and sweetest profile you can come across. That's the power of these youngsters. You just see, he has put it so short, so crisp. So Sahil Nair, he's with KPMG. He's a certified MBTI and NLP practitioner. Being a certified design thinker, he loves building with ideas. He designs prototypes to redefine human experiences. He runs a popular show just like that on his YouTube channel and has his own radio show on Spotify. Welcome, Sahil. And the last but not the least is someone who has been known to me for 3 decades, Dr. Sanjay Srivastav. He is the VC and MD of Manav Rachna International University. Earlier, he worked for long with MIT University. He is an avid follower of Bhagavad Gita. He has written books like Timeless Wisdom from Gita and Leadership. 36 scholars have completed their PhD under his guidance. That's something unique. And he's published more than 80 research papers and guided more than 350 dissertations. Welcome, Sanjay. With that introduction of the panelists and the moderator and the theme and the contest and the background, and with my greetings to all of you, so I hand over to Sri Anish to moderate the session. And post the moderation session, there will be an option, there will be a platform for the audience to interact with the panelist and the moderator. Over to Sri.
Thank you, GP, for such wonderful introduction and initiation of this phenomenal event today. My warm welcome to all of you. It's a very august panel that we've been able to put together, dear friends and colleagues, and all of you participants. A very happy Sunday morning, first of all, sending the Sunday morning greetings from the mighty Dholadhars in the Himalayas. I am sitting at a place called Dharamshala. That's where I'm addressing you all from, and it's an honor to be with all of you today. Critical capabilities for the new yuga. And then we put beyond the obvious. Today I want to start, I actually wanted to start from something else, but just now, in this moment, I thought, let me start from a story today. The story I'm picking from Chandogya Upanishad to set this context. The format that will follow is that I'll speak for about 8-9 minutes to set the context, then invite my panelist over a few questions. And after that, we'll have about 20 minutes for Q&As from the participants. And if you have any questions in between, you could keep writing it on the chat box. So this story is from Chandakya Upanishad. There was a great sage called Uddalaka. He had a brilliant son called Shvetketu. Sage Uddalaka wanted his son to be a great leader, a great spiritual leader. So as the tradition in those days was, he sent his son Uddalaka to a Gurukul under the guidance supervision of a great teacher there. Uddalaka spent almost about 12 years in that ashram, in that Gurukul, in that university, if we may call it. And after 12 years of study, he came back to his house to meet his father. Now look at the scene, imagine the scene. The father is sitting, the son Uddalaka is walking, and the father is seeing the son walking from a distance. And Uddalaka is walking with great pride. He's learned a lot. He's gathered a lot of skills. He's read all the scriptures. He's whatever he thought he must learn, he has learned all of that. And with a great pride, he walks to his father. Sage Uddalaka looks into the eyes of Shvetketu. Felt really sad. He's meeting his son after 12 years. But he felt really sad looking into the eyes of Shvetketu because there was a deep pride. Uddalaka asked Shvetketu. No, before Uddalaka asked, actually Shvetketu started showing a lot of his jnana knowledge that he had learned in these 12 years. He started throwing ideas, philosophies from this book and that book. Uddalaka was really hurt. And he asked the son, "Well, son, you've gathered all these capabilities, all these skills, all this knowledge that you've gathered. But have you found that, have you known that, knowing which everything is known?" Let me repeat the question. "Son, have you known that, knowing which everything else is known?" Shvetketu was stunned. He said, "What is that? I do not even know about that knowledge. What is that, knowing which everything can be known?" Uddalaka said, "Those are the critical capabilities we are talking about." Shvetketu could not understand a bit of it. Uddalaka said, "Okay, let me explain you. Go to that banyan tree nearby and pick the seed of the banyan tree." Uddalaka went to the banyan tree, picked the seed of the banyan tree. Father said, "Now break this seed." The son breaks the seed open. And Uddalaka says, "What do you find under the seed, in the seed?" Son says, "A small kernel in the seed." Father said, "Okay, break the kernel now." He breaks the kernel. Father asks, "What do you find in the kernel?" The son says, "Nothing." And the father says, "This is, my son, the nothingness, the great knowledge of the self, knowing which everything else is known. From this nothingness, this whole huge banyan tree comes. From this small seed, the whole forest has come. Have you known that nothingness?" The son is still confused. He says, "What is that nothingness?" The father says, "The self. You are that nothingness. You are the self from which everything emerges. Have you found the self? Or have you just gathered the knowledge from the outside? Have you got the critical capability of knowing the self?" Shvetketu said, "No, sir." Father son sends the son again on a pilgrimage. And now Shvetketu spends a few more years. In learning what we are talking today is about critical capabilities. He learns these critical capabilities, comes back to the father. And now when father sees the son walking in deep humbleness, the father just gets up from his seat, hugs the son. They don't utter any word. Father doesn't speak anything. The son doesn't speak anything. They just hug each other. And the father knows the son has got it. Friends, these are the critical capabilities we're going to talk about today. What is that, knowing which everything else can be known? These are the critical capabilities I thought we should talk about today, because, and there's a reason why we must talk about these critical capabilities, because, you know, almost about 70 years ago when we got independence, 200-300 years of slavery, and we were an absolute poor country on our knees. And when we got independence, we had to learn to know how to do things. Our entire learning was focused on how to earn a living, how to create things around us, because we were absolutely at the bottom of life. We had to raise ourselves. So those skills were very important for us. So we started learning a lot of skills. We started building a lot of industry. We started building a lot of institutions and all of that. But now I see with the pandemic and everything, there's a great shift happening on Earth. We're entering into a new yuga. In this new yuga, we need some really deep critical capabilities to move ahead. It is very interesting that Dr. V.P. Singh actually shared a great report with me of UNICEF in collaboration with World Bank. They talked about some critical capabilities, and they put these critical capabilities in four quadrants. The first quadrant was learning to know, that all our learning must focus on knowing things. This we've done in the last 70 years. The second quadrant was learning to do, that our skills must allow us to do things in life. This was also last 70 years. The third quadrant was learning to be. Just be, learning to be. We're not working on that so far. I don't see we as collective humanity in India especially working on that. The fourth quadrant was learning to live together. I think we're lacking there also, because if we learn to live together, we'll not have any conflicts. Or we will know how to beautifully, positively manage the conflicts. These two segments, learning to be and learning to live together, as per the UNICEF report in collaboration with World Bank, is something that Sage Uddalaka was trying to teach his son Shwetketu. Learning to be. And when you learn to be, you know that through which everything else is known. These I call the critical capabilities that we need in this new yoga. If you see in life, everything emerges from this self. Your world, your success, your happiness, your relationship, everything comes from the root of your own self. If the foundation of these critical capabilities of knowing the self, learning to be and learning to live together, if we don't work on this, if we don't establish that, we can't create a great outward manifestation. We'll just create a world of to do. We'll not know how to be. We'll just keep doing things and we'll forget how to be. Yeah? These are the critical capabilities. Just to give you an example to put this context correctly. You know, I often come across these skills, these capabilities that are very popular in, you know, a lot of institutions. For example, a capability of, or a skill of, communication skill. We've all heard about that. We might have gone through learning the communication skills. But where does communication originate from your being? Normally in these skills, we are taught how to communicate. We never taught the content of it, what to communicate. Because I can only communicate that which I feel in the deepest of my core. But most of the time, we're also taught to fake it. And when I fake my communication, there are two Hindi words I want to introduce today. There's something called swabhav, your own inner self. And there's something called prabhav, an influence from outside. Parkabhav, influence from outside. When I try to fake my communication to please you or to become a better negotiator, etc., etc., and if it is not coming from my deepest core, my swabhav, then A, I'm faking it. I'm not truthful to my own self. I'm speaking something which I don't believe in. B, it creates a disintegrated being in me. My thoughts, words and action are totally disintegrated then. Then I do not know what is my own swabhav. I had written a sher, I'll speak this in Hindi. Maine ek sher likha tha kuch din pehle. Ki hum mukhoton pe mukhote lagate hain aur phir un mukhoton mein ya to apna astitva kho baithte hain ya apna astitva bhool jate hain. We put so many masks on our face that after some point we either forget what is our true face or the true face is totally drowned under the baggage of these masks. And then we can never become a Shwetketu. Then all our knowledge is just acquired from outside. So it is very important to A, come to our Swabhav by inculcating these critical capabilities, and then purifying this Swabhav again by inculcating these critical capabilities. Before I end, I just want to say two more things on this. At one point of time, India was considered Sone Ki Chidiya. We had abundant material wealth and we had abundant wisdom wealth in this country. What did we do right to become Sone Ki Chidiya? Have you ever thought about that? Kuch to theek kiya hoga hum logo ne is desh mein. And if you look at that, in the ancient times, all our education was focused on learning to be and learning to live together. Let me prove how. Kuch naam, some names I'm going to share with you. There was a great rishi called Rishi Kanad. He is the founder of atomic theory on globe. There was another rishi called Rishi Charak. We might have heard about him. Father of medicine. We're talking about people 3,000 years ago, 2,500 years ago. There was another rishi called Shushrut, the father of plastic surgery. There was another sage called Varahamihira. He was an eminent astrologer, astrophysicist, if you want to call him. Sage Patanjali, we've heard, the father of yoga to keep for the physical and mental well-being. We had Rishi Bhardwaj, a pioneer in aviation technology. We had Rishi Kapil, father of cosmology. We had Sage Paninini, who for the first time in the world history wrote grammar of Sanskrit. Now, why I'm speaking these names? Because if you see, each of these names starts from sage or rishi. These were the people who were first established in beingness. They first mastered the critical capability to be, and then mastered the critical capability of learning to live together. That is how they became sages and rishis. And they pioneered these fields of from medicine to Ayurveda to yoga to cosmology to astrology. All our learning to do things in life came from our ability to be. The sages created engineering, science, everything came from that wisdom. These are the critical capabilities. I think we've entered into the yuga where now we must focus on these critical capabilities. And for that, we need to know what are these critical capabilities. So today's session is about that. I have four very learned friends and panelists today with me. I want to open the discussion now. I want to go to each panelist with some of these questions. Let's first understand, and I invite my first panelist, Dr. VP Singh. Dr. Singh, what in your view are these critical capabilities? I've not mentioned the critical capabilities. I've kept that as a secret. Let's hear from you, Dr. Singh. What are these critical capabilities?
Thank you, Acharya Anish. First of all, let me compliment you for sharing that invocative and provocative story of Udalak and Shvetketu. That story is symbolic in many ways, what we are trying to do today for next hour or so. And in fact, you recited a Urdu couplet, and I also want to start my deliberations, my thoughts with a couplet, Urdu couplet, sher as we say, which in its own inimical way conveys and captures the dilemma of today's yuga. And this sher goes something like this. कब चिड़िया के बच्चे उड़ना सीखेंगे कब चिड़िया के बच्चे उड़ना सीखेंगे सांप के बच्चे पेड़ पे चढ़ना सीख गए कब चिड़िया के बच्चे उड़ना सीखेंगे सांप के बच्चे पेड़ पे चढ़ना सीख गए We are living in a time that The opposite forces are much more smarter than we are. Saap ke bachche peed pe chadna seek gaye. The pandemic which we have experienced, the crises which are coming, looming large in front of us, whether it's the water crisis, crisis of environment, we are not learning as fast as we should. The other systems are learning faster. And it is very, very important that we should relook, revisit our own assumptions. And as Sri Rajneesh, you have rightly said that, you will recall that during last 2 months, all of us in this team of both Shala, Sadhu Sangh Foundation, we have been debating for last 60, 90 days, that what are the critical capabilities which are required, not only for young students of who are undergoing MBA or engineering, but also people who are of older generation. And in that search, we came across this research work, which Anish Ji, you just mentioned, this research work of UNICEF and World Bank, learning to know, learning to do, learning to be, learning to live. And these four buckets of learning system, which comprises 12 skills, and if I can request Chetna or Swati to share that slide so that all of us can be together on the same page. What are those 12 skills which are so important today to not only survive but to excel is becoming very, very vital. And so this is what the UNICEF and World Bank, they are talking about. And as you all can see, the 12 skills, from the top you can see learning to be together, empathy, participation, and then in learning to know, creativity, critical skills, problem solving, so on and so forth. These 12 skills in a way encapsulates a lot of things which are extremely important for survival. And the good news that only recently University Grants Commission have realized, and they have shared a dictate that business schools, engineering colleges, higher education institutions will have to spend time, money and resources on building some of these skills. Probably we are waking a bit late, but it's never late. And I think in times to come, if we can focus on those 12 skills, probably to a very large extent, we will be able to build the armory, the arsenal of critical capabilities, which will help us to move in next 4 or 5 decades. And we will have to continuously revisit these skills. And we will have to continuously learn, unlearn, relearn some of these finer nuances of life skill and becoming a responsible citizen. Because this 12 skill also talks about being responsible. And at Sadhu Sangh Foundation, the objective and focus is on building, creating a cadre of responsible citizen leaders, which should start at a school level and probably at a college level. And then it should continue for life of a human being. And it cannot be, that you teach these skills for 3 months and 6 months and forget. So we will have to create an ecosystem where people can come back to these 12 skills and citizenship education on a continuous basis. And we have some thoughts about which we will talk maybe a little.
Sure. Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Singh. Thank you, Dr. Singh. Let me invite now comments from Dr. Tanuja. What, Dr. Tanuja, you feel are these critical skills?
Thank you for the invitation. And it's a pleasure to be here and a challenge to speak after two, you know, very embedded practitioners in the domain. And I have a view of a teacher and a student. So I'm teacher by profession and student, you know, of Buddhist philosophy in Tibet House with under His Holiness, wanting to revive, actually reviving Nalanda text. Now, you know, one or two things which you talked about, possibly I like to connect. So one was, Anishji, you talked about nothingness. So in nothingness, there are two extreme possibilities. One is nihilism, nothing exists, and we create. I respect that, because then the creating part gets challenged. But the second is, but that, you know, the nihilism can also give us, you know, void and depression when something doesn't work out. Second is, I'm a student of that emptiness, shunyata, where everything exists, but it exists in the way it is. And the mind, the being, with the doing, knowing and doing, it starts putting colors in it, meanings in it. So true it is, when we talk about competencies, somewhere we really have to acknowledge that, you know, our being is very important. Mm-hmm. Knowing, which is external to ourselves, is dependent in origination. We take input from others. We take input, you know, from not only human, but non-human elements also. Our doing is limited to, you know, whatever we have been exposed to, and the being is something we are. So the very first competency, I totally agree, you know, here is to actually look within. And then possibly another competency which occurs to my mind is, you know, how to strengthen the voices which can nurture the being and the nature itself. So coming back to, you know, where I was, talking of emptiness, talking of shunyata, what I really understood that, you know, mind is an entity which can be conditioned. And the very first competency, you know, possibly should be strengthening the muscles of the mind, training of the mind to be in a way where we can coexist with others in nature.
Wow.
So possibly we call it team working, which is a very small, I would say, not enough jargon. You know, possibly we have to reinvent more in the language. I am, you know, not against any language, because inclusiveness is something we strive for. And if internet has been in English, then it has been in English, you know. But we really have to make an effort where we come out with a tag.
Critical capability, jo hum sab logon ko seekhna hai, wo ye hai ki humne sunna seekhna chahiye.
Good one, Dr. Singh.
Tanuja ji, you
have a feeling that when the muting happens, my muting is also happening. You know what? I think another competency, work within distractions and not lose our focus.
Wow.
And still strive for the things we want to believe in. We have conviction. So I am going back and knitting it again. So I'm a student of emptiness. Emptiness means, you know, we have everything within us. Aham Brahmasmi is another word for that. But the whole thing is what part of that we are accessing, and the part which we access becomes our competency. The very first competency I feel is strengthening of the mind, strength of the mind. So this being should not be, you know, totally externalized. Role models, heroes, we've done enough of it. We haven't actually helped the earth. So let us be a being which is, you know, very intrinsic, internal, listening to the inner voice. In a domain, we call it ethics. We always know what is right, but it may not be, you know, within the legal. I say in my classroom, I've shifted to ethics teaching, that ethics begin when the legality ends. So let's not exist in the world of compliance, which we do in the corporates, even as a citizen in many countries, thankfully not India. So the competencies which we really need is, one, I would say strengthening self. Strengthening self needs a lot of conviction. That conviction has to come from the early studies that each one of us are whole and unique. Each one of us have inherent Buddha potential. each one of us can actually do good and exist. And then second side, you know, the education comes do's and don'ts, external discipline, which robs us many times of the internal conviction. We need to work around it. And we need to build a competency where possibly we can say, but I did that and it did work. Because larger, you know, I have lived my life with students and the corporate executives and myself. And the one thing which I heard again and again, you know, I have to do that because otherwise I can't exist. So at this point, with a lot of the, you know, we will come again and other people are also wanting to speak. I just want to come out with the four lines. And four lines, in fact, ek Hindi ka bhi share maine sunke aapke liye socha tha main bolungi. लेकिन अभी तो मैं इसी से एंड करती हूँ. ये बुद्धिस्ट स्कॉलर शांति देवा जी की बहुत सारी वर्सेस हैं. केवल चार लाइन है, उसका एसेंस यही है कि शुड वी जस्ट बी समथिंग एंड हैव एन अक्वायर्ड कॉम्पिटेंसी विच इज नॉट मेकिंग द ग्लोब सस्टेनेबल और शुड वी थिंक ऑफ मोर. दिस इज द इंस्पिरेशन आई गेट. देन द फोर लाइन्स आर, it goes like that. Where would I possibly find enough leather with which to cover the surface of the earth? That's what we say all the time. We are helpless. All right. And we fit to the system and destroy ourselves in the process. So the another two lines are, I will repeat, with which to cover the surface of the earth, where will I find that leather? Two lines are, but wearing leather just on the sole of my shoes is equivalent to covering the earth with it.
Wow. Beautiful. So focus comes back to the self. The critical capabilities needed to nurture the self. Beautiful. Thank you, Dr. Tanuja. I come back. I now invite Sahil to share his views from the world of consulting and life. On what, Sahil, do you think are these critical capabilities for the new yoga?
Thank you so much, Anishji, for actually having me over. It's brilliant to be in this august company of so many learned people. And in the process of just listening, one has learned so much over the last couple of minutes. I think fundamentally, the Times of India spoke about the rise of millennials in September 21. And we said 1/3 of our Indian population are millennials. And 46% of our workforce are millennials, right? And being a millennial myself, let me bring that voice to the table. I think fundamentally, we're living in a very, very fractured society. And the reason why I say we're living in a fractured society is because if you just look at the millennials, there are three broad personas. The first persona is, if you look at all the characteristics that we've heard of, you want it here, you want it now, instant gratification, 2-minute Maggie noodles as compared to dum cooked biryani over a slow flame, right? We've really seen that. So that's the first persona of digital natives. From the time they've been born, we used to have Cerelac looking at our mother or our father. They have Cerelac looking at the iPad, right? And they've really grown up with that kind of an environment. And the other end of the spectrum are the people who, as you very rightly said, are faking it till they are making it. And therefore, they're living in this mirage of what we call as filters, whether they are filters on Instagram, whether they are filters in friends, whether they are filters on virtual backgrounds on Zoom. And I think that's the other end of the spectrum. And the one in between is what I typically call as old soul millennials. And if you all believe in the soul journey, I think these are the ones who are the misfits because they're neither digital natives, nor are they the ones who are trying to fake it till they make it. And they're the ones who are struggling the most. Now, if you talk about this generation that is comprising of these three personas in the workplace or in the country, what are we really looking at? We're looking at competencies that are all over the place. Because the first persona has it sorted, is aligned with expectations. I want it here. I want it now. No commitments, right? So they are in line with what they are positioned to be, and they are in that zone. Now, the question is, when they go back and interact with generations senior to them, they see a massive dissonance between what their parents or their grandparents lived and what they want to live. And therefore, the manifestation is to break free. If you go to the other end of the persona, which is actually people who are trying to fake it till they make it, they are finding what India is typically known for, all ways of jugaad. So I can just, even if I don't know the competency, if I don't know the competence, if I don't know how to go out there and make an impact, I'll find ways of jugaad to manifest in my behavior that gets me to where I want to be. I'll put on a filter that will make me smile, but deep within I'm crying. And therefore that dissonance somewhere clearly becomes visible. And the third one is the old soul. And the old soul millennial is actually finding purpose, is actually finding meaning, is actually finding, why am I here with so many people around me who don't even know what they want to do with their life? Because one day they're learning coding, the next day they want to go and be with Arnab on, you know, Republic, and the third day they want to go and win a Padma Bhushan without even knowing what they want to win it for, but they just want to win a Padma Bhushan. And I think this is the entire confused space that we need. Number one, as coming to your question on competency, I think immense amount of clarity, which, as many of you all have already said, starts with the self. So I think clarity is one key aspect. Second, I think as we build breadth, because that comes very easy because you remain on the surface, I think there is a massive need to build depth, because the only time when you get into the depth is when you understand the finer nuances of what works, what doesn't. Otherwise, you always remain on the surface. Beautiful. And the third key competency that I want to leave everyone with, at least from the way I view it, is the ability to be genuine. I think we've been so conditioned with the fact of saying different strokes for different folks. And we just go and, you know, be like the chameleon that keeps changing colors in the environment that suits ourselves, because we know that is the way acceptability will be a lot higher. And therefore, in the process, we are actually losing our own individual.
Beautiful. Beautiful, Sahil. Thank you. What a beautiful way of presenting it. I now invite Dr. Sanjay from his vast knowledge base. Dr. Sanjay, what do you think are these critical capabilities that we must have in this new yuga, beyond the obvious?
Thank you so much, Acharya ji, and Professor VP Singh Saab ko pranam karta hu, and all of you present here. You know, from past half an hour or so, I'm listening to each one of you very carefully. And by and large, being the fourth speaker, I have a lot of advantages as well as disadvantages. So let me start from my own research work, which I did way back in year 2006, published in Indian Psychologist. And then subsequently, I wrote a book which was published in year 2017, which talks about Gita ka Shashwat Gyan tatha Netritva ki Kala. So I am presenting this before you all, my own research work. And we have gone to Fortune 200 CEOs and did psychometric profiling and did factor analysis, the complete research-based work, which I shall be talking before you. To me, being an ardent student of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, I always find that critical capability factor is always dependent on Desh Kal Patra. So if you are talking to a 20 years old person, the critical capability would be different. To a 40 years, it would be different, and so on and so forth. But I feel that there are two important components which Professor Tanuja ji also talked about, that strengthening of self and strengthening of mind. And what we see the visible artifacts in terms of behavior. So I personally feel that behavior is our key which holds the key, especially for the critical capability. And this critical capability also takes me to the path of critical vulnerability. We are working on critical capabilities, but we are not knowing our vulnerabilities. And people are researching in a big way about the vulnerability of the individuals rather than consolidating on their critical capabilities. So I find that this exercise which you have started is absolutely right, especially for the young students of the university, where we have a spectrum from lower KG to the doctoral program to the postdoctoral program in our university. And I see very closely the context which we talked about: learning to know, learning to do, and learning to be, live together. And one of the pioneering work was done by Professor Dr. Karan Singh ji. He is also closely associated, and these are the four quadrants from past 30 years or so. Very closely I am observing and listening to him. He was working on this. And again, when he draw this, he again often quotes Maha Upanishad, which says, Ayam Nijah Paro Veti Udar Charita Naam Ta Vasudeva Kutumbakam. So the when we talk about our own Upanishad, things are plenty. This is the time when we have to put them in the right perspective. So I would say, to me, the critical capability factor would be one, our own behavior. And second, I would say management of mouth. Third, I would say if I know my critical vulnerabilities well, I am going to make a huge difference. As Sahil ji also rightly said, that we are quite perplexed how to present our what is our real self, how we give our projected self, and there is a huge gap between perceived self and projected self. And we are continuously striving what is right for me and what is not right for me. But if I think that if we are strengthening our mind and working on our own self, what in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Lord also talked about, if you are focused, the moment you are focused, you will become professional. Many people think that the word professional is of today of or of yesterday, or it has come from the word corporate. But I must make it clear that 5,000 years back, Lord of Shri in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, verse 39 of chapter 2, written, it was said, Vyavasayitmika eka buddhi kuru nandana bahu shakha hi anant buddhi avyavasayina. Those who are professional, they are gifted with leisurely focused sense of purpose, and they know where they have to go in life. Otherwise, it doesn't matter where you go in life. So if we are focused, we are going to achieve everything. And critical capability, if I know mine as well as my vulnerabilities, I am going to make a difference. I take a pause here.
Beautiful. Thank you, Dr. Sanjay, to bring this beautiful perspective from Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Very well said. I have a request before I ask the next question to all the panelists, because looking at the time and the clock is right in front of me, I would request all of you to be extremely crisp so that we can cover much ground. Just a request from all of you. My next question, Dr. Tanuja, to you would be, what do you think? So we've talked about the critical capabilities, and now we somehow have a list, or we somehow have an insight into that. How do you think these critical capabilities will help the organization and the individual? See, we are sitting in a corporate context or a business world context right now. I just don't want to get enlightened myself. My question must be that, you know, how is it going to benefit my organization also? So what do you think? How are these critical capabilities are going to help the organization and the self also? Dr. Taruja.
Number one, you know, nobody works alone in a company. So we work together. It's a dependent origination philosophy which works there. And we've seen in pandemic, you know, even if you're very, very self-sufficient country, you collapse when something happens, you know, and possibly we all end up individually rich or poor, whatever class or whatever caste or whatever. So to be very crisp, these critical capabilities, when strengthen the character of a person really is more comparatively, I would say, secure. It's an ongoing game. Sense of competition is revised. Mm-hmm. Then we can co-create we can be creative, and we can actually enrich the world, and we can exist in the similar creative, constructive mode in a company with better health in mind.
Wow. Beautiful, beautiful. You've defied yourself. You said, you know, professors can't speak, you know, crisply, but within a minute, you've, you know, shared such a beautiful perspective. Yogeshji, we'll just come back to you after in the Q&A session. You know, first, let's just finish this round so that we don't break the flow. Please. Yeah. Yes. So same question to you, Dr. VP Singh. How do you think are these critical capabilities going to help the organization? That's the context. And then, of course, the individual.
Anishji, let me again come back to those 12 critical skills we were talking, you know, what UNICEF and World Bank has identified. At the cost of time or repetition, let me once again capture it. Learning to know comprises basically creativity, critical thinking, and problem solving. Learning to do comprises cooperation, negotiation, decision making. Learning to be, which is basically self-empowerment, comprises self-management, resilience, and communication. And lastly, learning to live together comprises respect for diversity, empathy, and participation. The research proves that each of these skills or competencies have proven life outcome. When UNICEF and World Bank created this master list of 12 skills, they also, before recommending, they also did a research that does these skills impact the life of the individual, the learner, and the organization. And it is a very exhaustive research. We do not have time. I will encourage everyone to go back to this report, which we will share probably offline. And it very clearly ratifies that it has impact on the life outcome of the learner, which in the process will impact the organization in which he or she is working. So the proven fact, at this stage, I will not be in a position to say that how it is interrelated, but the fact is that these all competencies are interrelated and they impact you as a human being and ultimately in the ecosystem in which you work. I stop here.
Beautiful. Beautiful, Dr. Singh. Beautiful. So we shall share that research with all the participants later on. I have myself put a list of 10 critical capabilities, which I will share towards the end of this discussion with all the participants. Sahil, coming back to you. One thing is about the critical capabilities, but are they really going to benefit me as an individual and also support my organization? Because if it does not support the organization, organizations would have no interest in, you know, investing in those critical capabilities for the individual. Sahil, your take.
Same question to you. I'll keep it very crisp. Just two points from my side. I think fundamentally, for the longest time, we have been hierarchy-driven organizations. And therefore, that has been very self-limiting because if there have been insecurities of people or egos of people, a lot of creativity has got stifled at the bottom because of people at the top not letting people really rise. So I think we need to move away from a mindset shift of saying, everyone can be a leader, which means even at the junior most level, if a person can have leadership qualities, it doesn't need to be linked to hierarchy. That's point number one. And point number two, how organizations can benefit from this is by really calling out non-negotiables across levels. I think many a times we get caught up in this entire process of saying, if I take this action against this individual at this level, this is the side cost. And we do a trade-off more often than not. And that really goes across to talk about the culture to say at a certain level and above, this can be managed or is acceptable versus otherwise. So I think 2 points. One, a mindset shift to everyone a leader, bringing in situational leadership or whoever's the best person to carry people along, because just by matter of time or tenure or age doesn't mean that you have leadership capability. And the second is anything that could be a distraction or a derailment, whether it be insecurity, whether it be ego, or anything else, I think those should be called out as non-negotiables to really create enough precedent not to repeat itself.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So beautiful and crisp, Sahil. Thank you. Thank you for that perspective. Sanjay ji.
So to me, if I have to name in my own hierarchy, I would say the first one is critical thinking. Second one, I would say assessment and contextualization skills, which I have said in the context of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Desh Kal Patra. Third, creativity. Fourth is motivation. And fifth is reflectional skills. If we are working on these five critical capability factors, it will help the individual as well as the organization to reduce the so-called critical vulnerabilities in terms of confirmation biases, emotional biases, and rationality biases. I end up here.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. What a beautiful perspective. You know, when we were conceiving this topic and this event, I also looked at, you know, we're talking about leadership. We're talking about how to lead. What are the capabilities which will help me to lead better? So I kind of defined, you know, what is a leader? So LEAD. L means learning, not just to deal with the change, but to also be able to deliver in that changing scenario. And, you know, in the pandemic, we've seen that. The E would stand for, you know, after this learning, we must evolve as leader so that we are able to create an impact. So it is just not enough to just deliver, but we need to create an impact also. I said A after that, LEAD, A. After this evolution, you know, we must awaken to inspire others. Now, this is how it is linking to the organizational setup. That first, I learn to deliver. Then I evolve myself to create an impact. Then I awaken myself to inspire others. And lastly, in a lead, the D would be to disseminate this awakening to create a collective transformation. I feel if in an organization, if we look at these critical capabilities and bring this LEAD concept, then it is really impacting the organization and the productivity in a long run. So I just thought I'll share that with you before asking the next question to our panelist. Now, I think next question is going to be a little tough, but we'll try to kind of, you know, again, squeeze it in the time. And I come to Dr. Tanuja again. We've talked about the critical capabilities, Dr. Tanuja. How do we develop these? You know, this nothingness, let's say we talked about, or this creativity we talked about, or so many other, you know, the capacity to motivate we talked about. How do we cultivate these? How do we teach these? Your take.
Yes, it is a tall order, but very doable, because mind is trainable. Thankfully, we are conditioned animals. So we condition this way, we can condition another way. Then the signals are coming, you know, nature is collapsing, you know, the diseases are coming from forest inhabitants to the city. So all the signals, you know, are that we need to change. Mm. Still, we are resistant to change. We have to understand. So how do we actually change it? I would like to, you know, begin from the corporate where I have spent my, you know, most of the life. Teaching, reading, writing, training to, you know, whatever, consulting. And one thing I notice, for example, the entrance exam, you know, which picks up the best of talent. And then we have top company leaders out of that, you know, group is very much based on cognition capacity assessment. So we have invested so much on cognition, being aware, going in depth, mastering numbers, seeing data. We forgot, two things happened. One, I think somewhere we forgot to equally test the emotional part and invest in it. Mm. And the second thing is, you know, It's strange that by our cognition, we made AI, artificial intelligence is so equipped, we have replaced ourselves. So just to cut it short, because I'm sure others are really waiting to speak. Now we are replacing ourselves, we are obsolete, and that is leading to another level of destruction within corporates also. So we forgot that, you know, patterns can emerge through AI, but reading needs your mind expansion, possibly, you know, to build it. We have to sensitize our brightest of minds, and I would say all minds, because we have Buddha potential, towards, you know, more subjective viewing, more viewing through the lens of, let me use the concrete word, art, aesthetics, appreciation, you know, being the life, not only dying and work and working and dying. To build, I think, to just end it very conclusively, we have to invest a lot into other abilities except IQ and cognition.
Excellent.
We have to build emotional, you know, muscles, ethics of restraint, ethics of tolerance, you know, tolerating differences, working, you know, working on, unconscious bias, which is very difficult. A lot of work has started in companies, but it is absolutely like at the minimal level.
Yes. So, Excellent. And I think, Dr. Tanuja, that is what we're trying to do also. You see, by conducting these events, we are trying to create a narrative that at least let's start to think and know that these critical capabilities are needed, you know, enough of the skill sets that we've been, you know, imparting. Now we need to go to the core of beingness. So at least the narrative is starting to build up now, thankfully. Dr. Singh, what is your view on that? How do we impart this? And we've been deliberating on that, Dr. Singh, in our Bodhishala group. Your comments.
So, Anishji, I think the journey should start from home. It is the parents who should live and become the role model to cultivate these critical skills. So whether it is creativity, whether it is self-management, whether it is resilience, the parents are the teachers. The early teachers. So they have to role model, they have to learn. Sanjay told that he gave the trilogy of Desh Kal Patra. But I think the critical skills are relevant and valid for everyone. It is valid for someone who is at 72 at my age, and it is valid for somebody who is 7-year-old. It is not that these skills are not valid for me, but just because I'm 80-year-old. They are valid for everyone, number one. Number two, it is the parents who will have to learn and kind of practice and become role model. Teachers will have to. So that's how the journey has to start. These critical skills, if we are trying to teach somebody who is at the age of 35, working in Procter & Gamble, it will be very, very difficult. At the age of 35, I start teaching you how to be creative. It will be a mountain hill climb. But if you can teach somebody who is 6-year-old, 5-year-old, lot more easier. So it has to start early, number one. Number two, we will have to get into surrender mode. Sanskrit mein hum log kehte hain, samarpan bhav agar nahi aayega, to hum isko nahi develop kar payenge apne andar, dusron ke andar bhi. सेवा समर्पण संस्कृति और संतुलन ये चार चीजें नहीं होंगी इट विल नॉट बी इजी सो दीज आर माय इनिशियल कमेंट लास्टली बट नॉट द लिस्ट वी विल हैव टू रिवॉर्ड एंड रिकॉग्नाइज पीपल हु आर प्रैक्टिसिंग इट एंड अगेन लास्टली हम लीडरशिप की बहुत बात कर रहे हैं फॉलोअरशिप की कोई बात नहीं कर रहा
वाह सो वेरी वेल पुट डॉक्टर सिंह ब्रिलियंट एंड आई You know, looking at the conversation and your inputs from all of you, मुझे ऐसा फील हो रहा है this is really a vast subject. I don't think 1.5 घंटे में इसको हम थोड़ा छू भी सकते हैं. But as I said earlier, Dr. Tanuja को, that at least we've started to build the narrative. इस पर जितनी चर्चा हो, जितनी बात हो, उतना ये actualize होगा, उतना ये reality बनेगा. So I'm glad that somehow this process is initiated. Coming back to you, Sahil, what do you think? How do we create a world like that?
Anishji, I think for way too long, all of us have been on the treadmill. And we've been just continuously running on the treadmill. We haven't got time to pause, to reflect, and to process. Come to think of this, right? the last 2 years have been difficult for so many people. Some of us have lost loved ones. Some of us have actually gone through bad health scenes. But the quarter tak narrative still remains the same, right? I think fundamentally three or four things as far as the capability story is concerned. I think we got to make it known. A lot of people are in this space that since we're on the treadmill continuously, we're just moving. But there are a lot of blind spots that we need to, and I'm so happy that through sessions like these, and I see the chat where so many people are asking for the recording, because while they are listening in now, they want to sit back and hear it again and again, because I'm sure they see value in what is getting discussed. So I think got to make it known to say, what are the blind spots that because of a very, very high speed, you miss the blind curve because we're running so fast. Number two, from making it known, how do we make it real? To say, you've seen a lot of organizations and individuals who've really plateaued because they haven't really made it real. They haven't understood what's going to hit them, if not today, a couple of years later. And therefore, the critical imperative to saying you got to pause and make it real. And lastly, I think we got to make it stick. Because while so many people are doing so many certifications and putting it up on LinkedIn and here, there, and everywhere, I think deep learning, and Dr. Tanuja will agree with me here, I'm hopeful, deep learning is somewhere really missing. We're just trying to touch the surface. We're trying to add more and more certifications. But when we look within, I think it's not a certification journey. It's a lifelong journey. And I think we all need to take that time out to get onto that journey sooner than later.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So very well said, Sahil. And maybe, you know, that is the reason. This is a very, very important discussion for the institutions, for colleges, for universities, for corporate, because we're all seeing great resignation. I have friends who are calling me every other day, you know, they call me for a spiritual discussion, but they end up saying that, you know, boss, log nahi mil rahe company mein kaise kaam, dhanda kaise chalayenge. And then at the same time, I have so many of my ex-colleagues and friends who are saying that burnout, enough of it, get us a land in Dharamshala, we just want to live in peace. I think just because of the fact that we've not been able to focus on these critical capabilities, we want to run away, yeah, because we're not able to change the system, so to say. So, yeah. Sanjay ji, you've been in the education for many, many years, decades. Aapka view on this. How do we impart this?
Sir, how to inculcate this was the question.
Ji.
To me, if I talk about the, in terms of outcome, my answer would be renewal. And I say there are four important renewals, which I am an ardent fan and follower both. First is physical renewal. Hindi mein bolte hai navikaran. If we give 1 hour to our own self, strengthening our mind and self, it will give us two important attributes. First is character and second is commitment. So we, as an institution, we need to prepare a system. We need to ensure that we ensure on physical renewal. Now, because of the tech, social renewal again is a very important ingredient. And social renewal, if you teach it systematically, it teaches you how to communicate and where to put a full stop in the communication. Okay? And this communication also is the key for collaboration. Okay? And because of social renewal, we go from communication to collaboration to a team. And when I say team, what you said about lead, the four letter team to me is, T stands for trust, E stands for ego, A stands for anger, and M stands for mystic behavior. We need to train ourselves when to look within and when to look beyond, and when to put a full stop.
Beautiful.
The third important renewal mechanism is intellectual renewal mechanism. And if you see, if we are talk, ma'am, Tanuja ma'am talked about strengthening of mind, are we defining and talking to people at large that define your daily, weekly, monthly reading package? Because if you are not giving enough food to your mind, if you are not renewing your mind, you are inviting trouble. And I say intellectual renewal gives birth to curiosity, it adds to your competence, and it is the key to courage. Without reading, you cannot have enough courage to talk to anybody in the world. And lastly, what you are enjoying, the spiritual renewal. And when I say spiritual renewal, often we talk about Dr. V.P. Singh Saab, he is also known as Raj Rishi. And when you look at the calmness on the face of a person, it comes only from the spiritual renewal. There is no other way. And again, it is the mother of compassion. You cannot have compassion without spiritual renewal. If we follow it, I am for sure we will cultivate these capabilities. It is possible, very much possible. And I have given in simple black and white English. Thank you.
Beautiful.
अनिल जी मैं थोड़ा सा एक मिनट लेके जो संजय ने बात जो करी बात की है उसको थोड़ा बिल्ड करना चाहूँगा. संजय ने बेसिकली चार इंटेलिजेंसेस की बात करी है, फिजिकल, मेंटल, इमोशनल और स्पिरिचुअल इंटेलिजेंस. इसके नवीनीकरण की बात करी है, मैं इस पर जोर देना चाहूँगा. दूसरी बात मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा कि ये जो क्रिटिकल कैपेबिलिटीज या यूनिसेफ ने जो 12 स्किल की बात करी है, ये ऐसा नहीं है कि आप इसको एक बार पढ़ा देंगे, सिखा देंगे तो वो जीवन पर्यंत आपके साथ रह जाएगा. नहीं होने वाला है. वी विल हैव टू क्रिएट ए इकोसिस्टम इन विच और वेयर पीपल कैन गो अगेन एंड अगेन एंड रीलर्न, रेटिफाई, री इन्फोर्स माई सेल्फ मैनेजमेंट, माई रिजिलियंस. एंड अनिश जी, यू वुड नो दैट वी आर टॉकिंग एट बोथ शाला साधु संघ कि हम एक कैडर बनाने की बात कर रहे हैं, कि हम लोगों को एक बार नहीं पढ़ाएंगे. एक बार पढ़ाने से ये बात नहीं बनेगी. हम इसकी कंटिन्यूटी रखेंगे जो कि संजय बात कर रहे हैं. रिन्यूअल ऑन गोइंग होगा. ऐसा नहीं है कि हम एक कॉलेज के विद्यार्थी को हमने रिजिलियंस पढ़ा दिया या एम्पथी पढ़ा दिया, एक बार बात खत्म होगी. क्या वो हर साल हमसे जुड़ रहा है क्या, हर दूसरे साल जुड़ रहा है क्या? अगर वो होगा तब चीजें पुख्ता होंगी, मजबूत होंगी. आई थॉट आई विल ऐड दिस.
ब्यूटीफुल, ब्यूटीफुल डॉक्टर साहब, ब्यूटीफुल. एंड जस्ट टू गिव द कॉन्टेक्स्ट हियर, डॉक्टर वीपी सिंह और कुछ बहुत बहुत एक्सपीरियंस्ड मित्रों के साथ वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस फोरम कॉल्ड बोधशाला, वेयर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वेरी थिंग. एंड वी आर ऑल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट क्रिएटिंग इलेक्टिव कोर्सेज to introduce in the universities, elective courses, and also build this cadre that Dr. Saab talked about, and reinforce this, revitalize it every few months, etc. So I thought I'll just add to that. And yes, Tanuja ji.
Half minute I want to say.
Yes, please.
और थोड़ा हिंदी में भी बोलूँगी.
ज़रूर बोलेंगे.
कि दो बार जो है खाना अच्छा लगता है. एक तो जब बहुत भूख लगी हो, और दूसरा ये है कि जब पता ही नहीं हो, जो भी खाना मिल जाए, पहला बहुत एक्सपोज नहीं हो और वो खाना अच्छा लगता है. तो इसीलिए मुझे लगता है कि ये कॉन्टिन्यूस स्टेजेस हैं. और जैसा सिंह साहब ने बोला, एक तो अर्ली एजुकेशन में मसल बिल्डिंग बहुत जरूरी है. वो ऐसा ही है ना कि शुरू शुरू में खाना मिला तो आदत पड़ी, लेकिन बाद में बहुत सारा मेरा एक्सपोजर एक्सपीरियंस है डी यू में, MDI में, कि जब हम अपनी लाइफ में बहुत मिसमैच होता है, डिप्रेशन, एंग्जाइटी होती है, लाइफ स्टाइल डिजीजेज होती है, तब भी एक नई हंगर आती है. तो वहां पे पॉसिबली इलेक्टिव और लेटर एंगेजमेंट्स एंड कंटीन्यूअस ट्रेनिंग एट एनी लेवल कैन आल्सो बी हेल्पफुल.
यस,
तो बोधशाला शायद कंटीन्यूअस इन नेचर है.
यस, एब्सोल्युटली, वेरी वेल सेड तनुजा जी, वेरी वेल सेड. और जस्ट टू लेट यू नो एवरीबॉडी, वो तनुजा जी ने खाने का एग्जांपल इसलिए दिया, आई एम रिवीलिंग तनुजा जी, बिकॉज पिछली दफ़ा जब हमारी कॉल हुई तो उन्होंने कहा कि आई एम अ फूडी, मुझे बहुत तरह का खाना पसंद है, हेंस द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फूड. आई थॉट आई मस्ट शेयर. ग्रेट. ओके, लुकिंग एट द टाइम, allow me just 2 minutes to quickly share these 10 competencies that I thought we must all know and contemplate on in our own free time. And then I'll ask one last question before opening the panel to discussion. Yeah, the critical capability, main hindi mein inka naam leta hun, learning to live together, which translates as vasudhaiva kutumba, first capability. Now, this will provide a loving support to each other towards a collective vision. So, first competency. Sahe astitva, which means coexistence. Second competency. This means accepting each other's uniqueness. We're all unique people. Accepting each other's uniqueness. Third competency. Sense of belonging. Ek apnepan ka bhav. Which is, once we have that, we'll start to take ownership for each other. We're not individual anymore. We are a part of a collective. Apnapan. Fourth. Purposeful and happiness. Hindi mein bolein to prayojan wo anand purnata. Seeing and working towards the larger picture with joyfulness. So this is what will happen if we have purposefulness and happiness as the fourth competency. We will look at every challenge also with joyfulness, not seriousness. Huh? Fifth, creativity. Hindi mein bolein to srajanatmakta. It is the capacity to think fresh, to think really new, to look at a nature and get signals from that. Yeah, so that is creativity, fifth. Huh? Sixth would be equanimity. Sambhav, the capacity to remain centered in equilibrium, no matter what happens. Chahe achha ho, chahe bura, good result, bad results, positive, negative. I have the capacity, I have developed this critical capability to be in equanimity. Seventh would be kindness and humbleness. Remember the story which I shared with you, Uddalaka ki, huh? Karuna va vinaya shilata. Because if you're more learned, you would be more kind. If you're more learned, you will be more humble. And this will also create a new principle of reciprocity in human beings. We'll talk about it some other time. Seventh. Eighth would be self-restraint. Or Dr. Sanjay ji ne is pe baat ki. Atma sayam. When we're able to control ourselves, jab hamare upar, when we have this self-restraint capacity, Sahil ji ne bhi is pe baat ki, then we are able to develop a very strong willpower. So that would be the eighth. Ninth would be patience. Dhairya. 2 minute instant Maggie will not work in the new yoga. So we need to develop dhairya, patience. And last, tenth would be one pointed attention. Again, Dr. Sanjay ne Gita ke reference mein isme baat ki. Ekagrata. The capacity to, isme do shabda aur add karo, sama aur dama. Ye ekagrata ke do aur points hain, sama dama. Capacity to tame my own mind, which is my thoughts, and the capacity to restrain my senses, not instant gratification. If we are able to develop this, we'll have a very, very sharp focus in life. So these 10, I thought I'll quickly share with you as 10 critical competencies, which I personally feel are very needed in this new yoga. Okay. Now my last question to all the panelists, and I would request, you know, half a minute response on that. And I come to Dr. Sanjay on this. Dr. Sanjay, are our institutions of higher education somehow imparting these critical competencies? Dr. Sanjay.
Sir, with new education policy of 2020, the national education policy, we are now going to see a paradigm shift in the organization. And most of the private organizations, especially our institution from K-12 to higher education, our name is Manav Rachna. So we are totally committed to ensure that at the end of the day, you become a better individual, a good brother, sister, son, daughter, and wherever you go and work, make difference and bring laurels to your organization and to your institution and to your family and Mother India. So we are going in totality, and we have also created a complete package to ensure that when they join the portals of the university, until the time they pass out, we ensure they have one academic mentor. And then a group of students are given one mentor from industry. And they do the hand-holding and ensure that the student goes with a transformative journey as a person and to a professional.
Beautiful. Beautiful, Dr. Sanjay. I'm so glad, Manav Rachna. What a beautiful name and what a beautiful work. Brilliant. Tanuja ji, quick response on this. What do you think? Are we, as institutions, doing enough towards this?
बहुत अलग ख्याल है मेरे और मैं बहुत अपफ्रंट होना चाहूंगी नहीं हो पाएगा, क्योंकि या तो हम क्यूरियोसिटी की बात करें, या तो हम मेंटरशिप की बात करें, और या तो इतना आइडियल कॉम्बिनेशन हो दैट ह्यूमन माइंड कैन कम आउट विद इक्विलिब्रियम. सो और दूसरा देखिए, लार्जर कॉन्टेक्स्ट बहुत डोमिनेट करता है. तो अगर हम वेल्थ मैक्सिमाइजेशन एंड कैपिटलिज्म में हैं और बिजनेस इज डोमिनेंट सिटीजन ऑफ द ग्लोब इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया, तब वेल्थ क्रिएशन वुड बी एट कॉस्ट ऑफ एनीथिंग. तो स्टेक होल्डर थ्योरी की हम बहुत बातें कर रहे हैं अपने एथिक्स की क्लासेस में. द ओनली थिंग इज वो हमारा शायद इनहेरेंट, यू नो, इनहेरेंट सोसाइटी थी इंडिया में, मैं बोलूंगी, बट समवेयर वी आर शिफ्टिंग. So individual incentivization, profit maximization, capitalism, focus on, you know, market capitalization, at least in the business school, you know, would be challenges where it will be a little more challenging. And education system mein shift aa raha hai. I'm very hopeful, optimistic person. Buddha potential humare paas hai. So just to close, shift aa raha hai, aur shift aa raha hai because of the collapse of lot of empires. But mentorship and this aspiration, beautiful. But would it really work with a very informed, differently, you know, informed person, be it a student or executive who has internet and who believes in reverse mentoring, self-mentoring?
Yes. Very good. I'm glad you brought in such a practical aspect also here. Yeah. Beautiful. Sahil, your 30 seconds on this.
So Anish, I'll bring in two perspectives, one as a student of life and one as a visiting faculty at various colleges over the last decade and a half. I think fundamentally being an internal optimist, I believe that we're on the journey and it's not fair to really go ahead and paint everyone with the same brush and say, nahin ho raha. I would say in pockets it's happening. We need to speed up universally. If you just take a couple of seconds to go back to when we were children, we had a beautiful drawing book and we had crayons. And everybody taught us ki aapko ye crayon ko andar hi color karna hai, line ke bahar coloring nahi jani, right? And as we've grown up, what are corporates hiring us for? Corporates are hiring us for thinking outside of the box. Corporates are saying, what can you do different? How can you think outside of the box? And therefore, this is one end of the spectrum, which to me is a huge dichotomy, massive, which needs to get solved fundamentally, right? Because jis cheez se hum bade hue hain, wohi cheez agar corporate mang nahi raha hai, to industry academia mein gap badhta jayega. And secondly, at an individual level, each one of us like to upskill when the going gets tough. And we say when the going gets tough, the tough get going. But jab achha samay hota hai, tab hum cheezon mein invest nahin karte, kyunki tab hum maximize karne ki koshish karte. So I think that continuous journey, whether good or bad, we should be on that regular journey, because when the dip happens, you will rise faster because you build the muscle power as compared to saying, oh, now I've plateaued and therefore I need to do five things to come back to where I was. So I think two parts.
Beautiful, Sahil. Very well said, Sahil. Very well said. I love the crayons example of the school. Beautifully said. Dr. Saab, 30 seconds.
Acharya Anish, if things were as good as we want to be, we would not be debating. Sanjay, positivist here. संजय ऑप्टिमिस्टिक हैं, तनुजा जी बुद्धा पोटेंशियल की बात कर रही हैं, साहिल पॉजिटिव है, ऑप्टिमिस्टिक है, मैं रियलिस्ट हूं. मुझे नहीं दिखाई दे रहा, या जितना दिखना चाहिए उतना नहीं दिख रहा है. हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं, सतही तौर पे काम कर रहे हैं, सरफेस पे काम कर रहे हैं, डीप डाइव प्रोफाउंड काम नहीं हो रहा. लेकिन शुभ संकेत यह है कि यूजीसी इस पे बात कर रही है, न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी इस पे बात कर रही है. ये कितने गहरे में जाएगा, मैं नौकरशाहों के ऊपर बिल्कुल ही आश्रित नहीं होना चाहूंगा और उनके ऊपर विश्वास नहीं करूंगा. मैं विश्वास करना चाहूंगा उन प्रबुद्ध लोगों पे जो इस सभा में उपस्थित हैं, शायद ये लोग दुनिया बदलें.
क्या बात.
और आखिर में सिर्फ मैं ये कहूंगा कि ये बात और है कि आंधियां हमारे बस में नहीं, ये बात और है कि आंधियां हमारे बस में नहीं मगर चिराग जलाना तो हमारे अख्तियार में है।
क्या बात है, क्या बात डॉक्टर साहब, ब्यूटीफुल ब्यूटीफुल मास्टर स्ट्रोक। वाह वाह, वेरी वेल सेड डॉक्टर साहब, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। लुकिंग एट द टाइम एंड आई नो जीपी मुझे डांटेंगे इस बात पे। गुड गोइंग, यस यस। सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट द पैनलिस्ट इफ वी कैन स्ट्रेच इट फॉर 12 टू 13 मोर मिनट्स, देर आर लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वी हैव। अगर आप अपना समय 12 से 13 मिनट और दीजिए, वी विल टेक अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस। वी स्ट्रेच्ड अ बिट, ओके, यस प्लीज। यस ऑल डियर फ्रेंड्स इन द ऑडियंस, yes I keep yeah, I think just allow one or two question to continue with our yes, okay. I'm just reading. Okay, I take this question. Can we have critical capability built from the roots which would stand useful for carving the personality of an individual? Let me repeat. The question is, can we have critical capabilities built from the roots which would stand useful for carving the personality of an individual? Dr. Saab, your thought on that.
My answer is big yes. And there is no other way. Simple. Beautiful. You can't teach critical capabilities when somebody is 22-year-old or 25-year-old or 30-year-old. Or even if you can teach, it will remain surface. You can build foundation only from the beginning. That doesn't mean that I should not teach critical thinking, problem solving to somebody who is 45. But I would prefer to start when the boy or a girl is in 7th or 8th year of his or her life.
Beautiful. Beautiful. The earlier we start, the better it is. Excellent. Excellent. I'll take one more question. And this is from Yashwant Chauhanji. He says, how can organizations focus on building the sustainable leadership? How can organization focus on building the sustainable leadership? Dr. Tanuja.
Thank you. I'm just editing a Springer book on the same topic, Responsible Leadership for Sustainability. In uncertain times, it is possible. There is a beautiful literature if you are interested. The very first thing, just to come to the pointed answer, we have to shift. Now, first I'm talking for the business, then it also goes to the government and the public. So for the business and the governance, shareholder wealth maximization actually needs to be questioned. And stakeholder orientation needs to come. There are lovely companies coming out with the best practices. We actually need to make them mainstream talk. So one, and second is for sustainability, there's a, which we discussed today, inherent, understanding of that we exist together and we exist with nature. So possibly early imprint, as Jaisa Singh Saab ne kaha, early imprint from school onwards, but we are never late. We are learners at all stages. Early imprint, respect others and the nature. इसको धर्म बना लें, इसको अगर धर्म बना लें, टॉलरेंस पेशेंस को धर्म बना लें, क्योंकि सस्टेनेबिलिटी जो है वो हमारे वो सेम एक्शन को रिवाइज करके आएगी, जहाँ पे हम ये देखें तो हम कॉस्ट बेनिफिट करते हैं हमेशा. सो कॉस्ट हम कितनी इनकर कर रहे हैं, तो पहले हम नेचर की कॉस्ट नहीं करते थे, दूसरों के इलनेस की कॉस्ट नहीं करते थे, पर अब जो इतने इन्फेक्शियस इलनेस है हमको पता है कि उसको अकाउंट करना पड़ेगा. तो जस्ट टू कंक्लूड, वेरी मच पॉसिबल, वेव हैज स्टार्टेड, अभी इट इज एट द बॉटम ऑफ द, वी कैन मेक कलेक्टिव एफर्ट एंड कैन एक्चुअली गेट इट ऑल अक्रॉस. दिस इज हाउ वी क्रिएटेड 80s एंड 90s, वी शिफ्टेड टू कैपिटलिज्म, एंड दिस इज हाउ वी कैन शिफ्ट टू ह्यूमैनिटी एंड ह्यूमनिज्म.
ब्यूटिफुल ब्यूटिफुल डॉक्टर तनुजा, ब्यूटिफुल. And I think we'll take one last question now, yeah? It's an interesting question from Anandita Ji. And she asks, what critical competencies will save families from breaking up under workplace stress and profit maximization? I thought an interesting question. I'll repeat. What critical competencies will save families from breaking up under workplace stress and profit maximization? Sahil, your thoughts on that?
Should I answer?
Yes, please. Please, Sanjayji, go ahead.
To me, if I would say in simple English, unconditional positive regard, genuineness, empathy, realistic expectation, and give time.
Beautiful. Am I audible? Okay, good. So with that, there are a lot of other questions, but I think time is not permitting us to go ahead. GP Raoji.
We'll send them the answers to each one of them. But before we call it a day on the question answer session, Sahil was given the question, one critical competency which will prevent that breakdowns. One critical competency, Sahil, only one.
I think, GP, mutual respect. Very important. One. Mutual respect and acceptance from where people come and their thought process is very important. That will avoid breakdowns.
Wonderful. Today on this topic of critical competencies, I could see that a lot of critical thinking has gone. And people also raised a lot of critical issues. And the panelists and the moderator critically evaluated, examined, applied their critical thinking and gave some critical responses and insights and some direction. So the journey has started. I was very happy when Dr. Singh said, I'm not positive, I'm realistic. But then I see a ray of hope in that when he said, bhai, that Andhi ka baat bula, chirag ki baat. So I think we let us use this platform, people who are joined here, and your well-wishers. So each one has got 50 well-wishers. We will be having lots of people. Why not we take the mantle, take the guidance of Sri Ranish and great people like the panelists today. Let us create some platform where we exchange views and identify the critical competencies that we give an edge coming to the corporate and industrial entrepreneur world, and let us help prepare them. So I think that can be a great contribution by all of us. With that, I will request each of the participants, please give one learning that you taking away today, one takeaway that you have pointed out today. If you write in the chat box, that will become a treasure of learnings, that will be a treasure of takeaway. Instead of I summing it up or request someone else to sum it up. In lieu of the summary, each participant will summarize by writing down one takeaway or one learning. When together, we'll create a treasure of learnings and takeaways. Over to all of you. And I propose a vote of thanks to Anish for wonderful moderation and all the panelists, Dr. VP Singh, Sahil Nair, Dr. Tanuja, Dr. Sanjay, for a wonderful session today. And all the participants for your presence, your support, and your interesting questions, and your solidarity with this journey. And of course, the Sadho team and all other organizations who helped us in this journey. Thank you so much. Wish you a great day. And we'll all be a part of the great journey. The journey of creating a new humanity with an awakened leadership. All of you will be a part of this. Thank you. Thank you,
Dr. Rao. Thank you very much. Thank you to all the panelist friends. Thank you to all the participants. It has been a phenomenal discussion, and I think we must have much more of these going forward. Thank you very much.